In this video, we will discuss about virtual private network and risk associated with VPN. Testing concept: what is virtual private network? Let us understand this with an example. Our internal network. In few instances, it may require to get our remote location connected to our internal network. Remote location may be branch offices or home, but getting connected through internet is not a safe option. So in such cases, internet is converted into private network through VPN service provider. In VPN, security is provided with use of dedicated circuits or with tunneling protocol. Let us recap what we learnt in last slide. A virtual private network is used to extend a private network through use of internet in a secured manner. Prime objective of VPN technology is to enable remote users and branch offices to get connected to the internal network. A VPN is created by establishing a virtual point-to-point connection through use of dedicated circuits or with tunneling protocols. VPN technology will reduce the risk associated with sensitive data traveling in open public network. Let us discuss some key aspects from exam perspective. Most prevalent risk of virtual private network. Entry of malicious code into the network. One of the prevalent risks of VPN is that firewall cannot adequately examine the encrypted VPN traffic. So if a remote computer is compromised, chances are there intruder may send malicious code through VPN to enter inside the organization's private network. What is the most secured and cost-effective method for remote access? For remote access, most secured method is virtual private network. Let us practice some questions. With reference to VPN, which of the following setup area is area of most concern? Computer located at employee's home is getting connected through VPN. Home computers are considered as having less security as compared to other computers. If a home computer is compromised, attacker can attempt to enter the organization's internal network through virtual private network. Which of the following ensures security in a virtual private network? VPN uses data encapsulation or tunneling method to encrypt the traffic payload for secure transmission of the data. Data diddling is an attack method. Data hash and compression will not ensure data confidentiality. So data encapsulation is basically process of hiding the data. Function of a virtual private network is to objective of virtual private network is to hide the data from the sniffer. VPN uses data encapsulation or tunneling method to encrypt the data traffic for secure transmission. VPN does not provide other functionality as mentioned in option A, option B, and option D. Which of the following is most prevalent risk of using VPN for remote login? We already discussed this. One of the prevalent risks of VPN is that firewall cannot adequately examine the encrypted VPN traffic. If a remote computer is compromised, intruder may send malicious code through VPN to enter inside the organization's private network. Unauthorized access can be controlled through encryption. Logon spoofing can be addressed by two-factor authentication. VPN does not directly impact the availability of the network. For a small organization, most economical and secured method for connecting a private network over internet is VPN technology will reduce the risk associated with sensitive data traveling in an open public network, and it is also one of the most economical method as compared to other options. Dedicated lease line is quite expensive. Other options are not secure enough as compared to VPN. Most comprehensive method to protect a remote access network with multiple and diversified systems is again virtual private network. A virtual private network is used to extend a private network through use of internet in a secure manner. Firewall, IDS, and DMZ is used to filter and control traffic between internal and external network. But for remote access, VPN is more secured and more comprehensive. Thanks for watching.